Hello and welcome to the course CS353 Grid Computing. This is the second lecture of module 5 and in this lecture we are going to talk about grid monitoring system. So let's begin. We are going to cover two things in this particular talk. One is called the basic requirements for grid monitoring system and we are going to talk about the existing grid monitoring system. So before I'll discuss the entire thing, let me first introduce or maybe recall you. Remind you the previous talk. In the previous talk we are talking about your grid monitoring architecture. So what we have talked about grid monitoring architecture, we say that there will be three components involved in a grid monitoring system. Okay, so who are the components? One is called the consumer, second one is called the producer, and the third one is called the directory services. Okay, services, and it is something like this. Let's say there is a grid computing environment present. This is your grid computing environment. Okay, in this environment there are several resources. Let's say this is R1, R2 resource, R3 source. So resources can anything, R1, R2, R3 resources. So what the producer will do? The producer is nothing but it is a sensor. So let me draw with another, means it is a overall idea only. I am just talking about an idea. So let's say this is a sensor. I'll put here, this is another sensor and this is another sensor. These sensors will collect the data about all these resources. Fine. Sensors are collecting the data about these resources and they store the metadata over here. What do you mean by metadata? It is something like, let's say producer is, suppose this is producer P1, producer P2, this is producer P3. So he can register something like this. P1, I am P1 and I am managing R1. So P2 will register himself. So he will tell that I am P2 and I am managing R2. Similarly, P3 manages R3, right? So there are several consumers. The consumers, I am representing with a man symbol. So these consumers want to monitor the resources. Okay, so what is the current status of a resource? So what they will do is, they will directly go to the directory services. They will contact the directory services. Let's say he want to know the status of R1 resource. Let's say this is a person. Let's say this is a consumer C1. This is consumer C2. So consumer C1 wants to know about R1. So how he could able to know? He will searches for the producer who is actually giving the data about R1. So he will contact the directory services, right? So let's say C2 also want to know about R2, then he will again contact the directory services. This is your directory services. So after contacting this, he will register in the directory services for to know the status of R1 and R2. Okay, or monitor the content of R1 and R2. So after contacting the directory services, he will able to know who are the producers who manages them, right? After getting the producer name, let's say C1 is able to know that this R1 will be managed by P1, so he will now query to P1 about the data of R1. Okay, so he will ask some questions to P1. Hello P1, is the kindly send me the data about R1. Now the data of R1 will be sent from your P1 to C1, the customer or the consumer. Similarly, C2 want to know about R2. So he will contact P2 and P2 will provide you the data. Okay, this part we have already discussed. So directory service is nothing but it is store information about the consumer and producer. Producer registers info about monitored event. So he will register this and consumer can register event of interest. Okay, this is how the registration process will be done at the directory services. And the consumer is nothing but what? Consumer is an entity It can be a user, it can be a grid subsystem, or it can be any application tool that demands monitoring of certain resources. Okay, this is how the things are going on, as we have discussed in the previous requirement. So to create this architecture, means the role of consumer, producer, director, service, after knowing the role of all these things, we need to create an architecture. So that architecture is nothing but that is called grid monitoring system, GMS. Okay, I want to build a grid monitoring system. So what is a grid monitoring system? Who constitute the constitute consumer, producer and director services? So I want to build a GMS which could who could do all these things. Besides that, what should the GMS constitute, means what are the different features should be included inside a GMS, that we are going to discuss in this lecture. I hope you understand what we are going to cover in this lecture. Then we will talk about the existing grid monitoring systems. So there are several grid monitoring system was already been developed and some are in the process of development. So we also talk about the already been developed GMSs in this lecture. So there are two things we are going to cover in this lecture. So let's begin with the basic requirements for grid monitoring systems, means what should be the features of a grid monitoring system when we are thinking about developing a grid monitoring system. So let's begin. First feature is sensor management. As I have already told you, in your architecture there are several sensors. These are the producers who are constituted of some sensors. Sensors generate events because they are monitoring these resources. So every event which will be generated by the sensors or the producers. Okay. So your grid management system, whatever software you are going to develop, your grid management system should able to manage all the sensors remotely. Okay. System has to provide mechanism for configuration and control of remote sensors. Okay. So that is the first feature your GMS must constitute. Fine. Second, publish and discovery. So what to publish, what to discover? Discovery is for user, publish is for your sensors or producers. Okay. So user means your consumer. So your GMS system should monitoring systems has to enable mechanism for sensors or producers to publish information and for users to discover information about the resources. Got it? The third point is your data archiving. Data archiving means monitored data repository should be implemented, which can be used for application performance analysis and resource utilization statistics. So only managing or only discovering and publishing the event is not sufficient. We have to store the data collected by the sensors. So here the sensor will collect about the data about the R1. So it should be stored somewhere. After collecting the data, it must be stored somewhere in the database or archived somewhere. So every producer need to store this data. So whenever a user or whenever a consumer asks about the data, he should provide it. So what the consumer will do with that data? He will try to analyze the performances. So performance analysis, and he would able to know the resource utilization statistics, because there are several resources, which resource is used much of the time and which resource is free, how much consumption has been done for a particular resource. Let's say this is a CPU, then how much people has been registered with this resources. So those things has to be taken care of by your GMS. Okay, so fourth point is non-intrusiveness. Non-intrusiveness means monitoring system has to be designed in a way that measurement process does not affect the monitored system. So there will be a measurement process that is going on in every resources. So whenever you are monitoring that system, then the measurement process should not be affected. That must be taken care by your GMS. Okay. Then the next part, before I discuss, let me change the color. Might be it will be not visible. So the next point is your extensibility. Extensibility means, let's say we know that your grid system, generally grid infrastructure is what? A grid environment is potentially a complete globally distributed system. Isn't it? That involves large set of devices and it is geographically distributed components. Okay, and it is used by many applications. So if you think about a grid environment, this is a grid environment, then the grid environment is dynamic in nature. Okay, so if it is dynamic, your GMS is going to handle this dynamicity. Means if suppose today there will be a resource is created and in the second day that resource is destroyed. Now if your producer is looking after this resource may be destroyed in the next day, or maybe a new resource came up in the system. Okay, so your GMS system should be extensible. Means you, for example, it should be possible to design sensor for specific resources or implement alternative message protocols. For specific resources, your GMS could able to develop a sensor so that he can manage those resources. That shows the dynamicity of your grid computing environment itself. Then third one is your interoperability. Interoperability means we know that your grid system is not alone who is running. Suppose these are the grid resources. This is your grid resources. Above the grid resources, there will be a middleware. Okay. And maybe this middleware grid resources has been managed by some GMS previously. Now you have developed another GMS. So your GMS should be incorporate or we can say friendly manner. He can join directly with this to manage the network. So it is something like this. Monitoring system should be able to cooperate with the other grid middleware system, okay, such as execution data, security management. In addition, it should be able to cooperate with other monitoring systems. So there are some other monitoring systems are there, middleware are there. So they should cooperate with each other to operate or to manage the entire grid environment. The next one is your scalability. Scalability means what? System architecture has to be able to support large scale dynamic environment comprised of numerous monitored resources. So there are, as we have already talked about this in extensibility, so more or less extensibility and scalability are related. So in scalability, as I have already told you, a new resource can be created any moment and the old resources may be destroyed at any moment because it is a virtual environment and anytime the resource will come and go. Okay. So scalable means your GMS should also be support this type of facility, or as it is comprised of numerous monitored events, so there are several means huge amount of resources available in your system. So your GMS should be capable to, your GMS should be scalable, means it will be it should be scalable. How could I define it? Scalable means scalable. So scalable should be more so that he can manage all the resources over there. Then finally, the security. Your grid monitoring system has to provide basic security mechanisms. So security mechanism includes your authentication, authorization, secure message transport. So all these features must be included in your GMS. So system that can implement security internally or use external security system. So anything can be used. Okay. So until now, what we have discussed? We have discussed the features your GMS should have. Means whenever you are thinking about developing a grid monitoring system, your monitoring system should have these 8 features. Okay. If your GMS providing these 8 features, then that is the best GMS until now, we can say. Not only people are trying to develop these GMSs, but the thing is, no GMS has already been developed who can support all these features. So there are several GMSs are available, but nobody is able to provide all the features. And new GMSs are already in the development process. So maybe they are able to provide all these features too. So in the next section, as I have already talked about, that we are going to discuss two things. One is called your basic requirements for grid monitoring system, which is completed. Now we are going to discuss about the existing grid monitoring system. So for this part, let me put you an announcement that in a existing grid monitoring system means we are going to talk about some developed, already been published and used GMSs, which are currently used in your grid computing infrastructures. But the architecture and everything, discussion of everything will be quite impossible in our talk. in this particular term. So I will prepare a overall features, and that overall feature will sometimes be understandable, sometimes be analyzable, or sometimes be means you have to grasp the things from the statement itself. So I'm not going to explain the detailed feature of this because every great GMS has its separate architecture. So if you are going to discuss about the architecture of every grid monitoring system, it will take around maybe around 6 months to complete your course, because there are huge amount of grid monitoring systems are available. You will be going to know about all those things. Means I am going to tell you the names, but I will not discuss everything. I will discuss only six grid monitoring system that we are going to discuss. Means the features of that, not the architecture and all. For the examination perspective, you should remember these features. Maybe I will ask the difference between two grid monitoring systems and all. But I cannot explain the architecture, or I will not ask you the questions about grid monitoring architecture and all. So let us first discuss the first existing grid monitoring system, that is called Ganglia. So this is a Java based system that performs host monitoring. It is widely used for cluster monitoring. Okay. So you know what is a cluster monitoring, and it is a Java based system. There are several features of Ganglia. What is that? Multicast based communication. What is a multicast based communication? Unicast means between one system to another. Multicast means from one system to a group of system. Okay, group. The group must be previously defined. But what do you mean by broadcast based communication? Broadcast means all the system. Multicast means a group of system. Okay, fine. Then hierarchical information management. Okay. Web interface extensibility. So it provides a web interface through which you can manage the system. And the last feature is XML data format message usage and interoperability with Globus MDS. Okay. So it means as I have already told you, interoperability means, if you remember, we have talked about a feature that is called interoperability. That means it should cooperate with other GMS and the middlewares. And we know that Globus MDS, that MDS stands for monitoring and discovering system. Okay. Globus MDS will be used in most of the systems. So this Ganglia will be compatible with your Globus MDS. Okay. This is act as a middleware system maybe. And this is also a monitoring system obviously, but this is act as a middleware system sometimes. This is the existing middleware. This is the existing monitoring system. So Ganglia is compatible with this. So that is interoperability features will be intact, fine. Then Ganglia is continued over here. Ganglia maintains data archive in round robin database. Okay, so he is maintaining the database. If you remember, I have discussed about the features that is called your data archiving. So that data archiving features will be supported by your round robin database. Then your Ganglia comprises of three components. What are they? Gmon, Gmetad. Gmon stands for, Gmon is a component that performs host monitoring. Okay, and Gmetadata, that is your metad, is used for aggregation of data from Gmon or your Gmetadata services. Okay, and graphical web portal means the portal through which the user can contact with the grid monitoring system. So that is all about your Ganglia. These are the different features of Ganglia. And the second one is your NWS. NWS stands for Network Weather Services. It's a system that, for host and network monitoring. So he will be able to manage the network as well as host. Besides for monitoring, NWS has the ability to predict resources behavior in close future time. So he can able to predict the future, means predict the behavior of a resource. Okay. Then information is stored in LDAP like databases. So for, as I have already talked about this, that is your round robin database managed by your Ganglia, and it uses LDAP like database. In addition, it is possible to integrate NWS with MDS. So it also supports MDS, and it is used by various execution management system like APST, GridBoss, etc. Okay. Furthermore, NWS enables remote sensor management. So he is able to manage sensors. If you remember, the features we have already talked about, the first feature is sensor management, and which is supported by your NWS, right? Then however, NWS lacks supports for security mechanism. So this feature has not been supported by your NWS, which is the requirement for the last one, as I have already talked about this. So the last feature is security. So this feature is not there in NWS. Then the next grid monitoring system is your INCA test harness and reporting framework. I forget to remove this one. This is 11 means this is the 11th paper he is talking about. So forget about this. INCA test harness and reporting framework performs automated testing, verification, benchmarking and information management of grid middleware services and other software installed on resources. Okay. So this work has been done by this. So he will be able to automate test, verification, benchmarking and even these things will be supported by INCA. It is mainly used to verify that all grid software components are probably installed and operational. So he will try to manage the softwares which are already installed on the grid components, and whether it is operational or it is not operational, all those things will be managed by your INCA. INCA can be integrated with MDS system, so integration is possible, and uses RRD, that is round robin database for data archiving, and it is still under development. So it is under development, it is not yet finished. Okay, fine. Then the next monitoring system will be your NetLogger, the network application logger toolkit, that is NetLogger. Is a system for application monitoring. So it is generally used for the application monitoring, not host monitoring. NetLogger provides an API, application programming interface, that grid application developer uses to add sensors in the application source code. Once the monitoring event takes place, system adds timestamp and some additional host and network information. Okay. Then finally, NetLogger, this data is then transferred using the XML based protocol and to remote computers and computer from which the job was submitted. So the data which is collected during this monitoring event will be transferred, and this data will be represented by XML based protocol. NetLogger provides basic networks and host sensors and graphical interface for presentation of events, but lacks security mechanism. So it is also lacking the security mechanism over here. Then the next one is your Mona Lisa. Mona Lisa is a grid monitoring system based on Genie technology. Mona Lisa does not provide sensors, but only information management, archiving and presentation component. As we have already discussed, what do you mean by information management, archiving and presentation components? Due to the Genie based implementation, it is very scalable, autonomous and easy to install. Okay. Integration with various monitoring systems and protocol is possible. Mona Lisa is lack of security mechanism again, and interoperability with grid middleware system. Okay, so it is not interoperable. Means if the middleware system is MDS, that has already been talked, Globus MDS, so it is not interoperable with the system. Then the final one that we are going to discuss is your Globus MDS, that is the middleware, which is also a monitoring system, monitoring and discovery system. Is monitoring system developed as a part of Globus toolkit, and it is a mandatory MDS which is present in all means entire grid system itself. So many of the grid infrastructure uses this one. So MDS main goal is information management, although it provides simple host monitoring sensors. There are several versions of MDS, like MDS2 is a LDAP based implementation, that is a database which is part of the Globus version 2.x. MDS3 and MDS4 are OGSA based implementation, which are the part of Globus version 3.x and 4x. Okay, so there are several versions of MDS existing over there. MDS2 system is comprised of information provider, grid resource information service and grid index information service. So these are three components of MDS2. So what is GRIS? GRIS service gather information from sensor IP on the host. And what is GISS? GIS is sort of directory service which enables GRIS and GIS service to register monitored event. Okay, so these are the six existing components for which I have collected the data from the paper, but there are several other monitoring systems exist. So I have just given a list of that monitoring system. For each one is a separate paper, means a research paper. So if anybody interested to know more about this, they can ask for me for the paper. I will download the paper and send to you. Anybody want to know more about these papers, So those monitoring system like autopilot, control and observation in distributed environment, that is code, grid IC, grid portal information repository, grid RM, then your Hockey, then your Java agent and monitoring and management, that is your JAM, Map Center, Mercury, relational grid monitoring architecture, VSPOF, then your mid grid mon. So that these are also the grid monitoring systems. Okay, so if anybody want to know the architecture or the detail or the previously discussed six different grid monitoring system, any paper, if anybody want, he can just contact me for that paper. Fine. So we have collected this information from this paper, that is your CRO grid monitoring architecture. You can directly read this paper. And some, so that the last part means the other monitoring systems that was collected from this book. So you can read the content from the book itself. The book contains a larger information about these systems. So you can go directly to that book and read about these systems. That's all for the today's class. Bye bye.